Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing another comparison and test of the heart rate accuracy between the Amazfit Bip U as well as the Honor Band 6. And by the way, if anybody tells you that they love Great Britain for the weather, trust me, they're pulling your leg. Anyway, let's get into it. Okay, so basically we've got the cheapest trackers from Honor as well as from Amazfit on the comparison and test today. So the Honor Band 6 came out about 6 months ago and it absolutely blew us away because it's got a huge 1.47 inch AMOLED display. So it's got a beautiful bezel-less display which goes edge to edge, and this is on a 35 pound or 40 buck tracker. Then on the Bip U, same price, but we got a slightly smaller screen, 1.43 inch, although it is on a TFT LCD display, so it's not as beautiful and as magnificent as the AMOLED, but nonetheless, it's still very bright and it's big. So if on the Honor Band 6 we have an elongated display, on the Bip U we have a more squarish display. Now, if you have been watching the WesKnows Tech News and Reviews channel, you would know that I absolutely adore the Honor Band 6. But the Bip U is also great, and I love the fact that it's got a nice big square screen. The only thing that I do mind about the Amazfit Bip U is the fact that it does have this lower lip, and it does say Amazfit, but I just think it would look much better if it was just simply square, something like the Fitbit Versus of this world. Anyway, so we've got these two trackers. What can I say? The Honor Band 6 is, of course, better looking due to the AMOLED display, but it does have less functionality in terms of it's only got 11 sport modes. It's only got two sport modes which are automatically detected, while on the Amazfit Bip U, we've got 60 sport modes. That's absolutely amazing. Now, all of these sport modes on both trackers are actually goal-based. So that means that if you're going out for a run, you can actually set a goal such as distance, time, or calories to be burnt. Also, both trackers are actually waterproof or water-resistant up to 50 meters. So you can take them to the pool with you and they will be able to calculate how many laps you've swum. They can also auto-detect your stroke. Now, you can't do open water swimming with them because they don't have inbuilt GPS. Both of these trackers actually use connected GPS. That means that you still need your smartphone to calculate your distance, speed, and so forth. Now, if we talk about common functionalities like your timer, your stopwatch, your alarms, your weather widgets, these trackers do it very easily. In regards to the more complex or the advanced functionality, something like your sleep tracking, well, both of these trackers actually register three sleep stages, so your light, your deep, and REM sleep. So when you go to sleep in one of these trackers, or both, as I do occasionally, you will actually see your going to sleep time, then you will see your sleep cycles, as in your light, your deep, and REM sleep, and then your wake up time. So also, when you go to the app, you'll be able to see a sleep score in regards to the sleep quality during your sleep hours, and of course guidance and advice on how to improve your sleep quality. Now, the Amazfit Bip U is also more advanced in the fact that it gets Pi, and Pi is your personal activity index. Now, this is a single value which basically tells you all about your respiratory health, and basically it sums up your activity over the last week. It looks at the intensity with which you performed particular activities, and then it provides you with a single value that ranges from 0 up to 100 plus. Why is this so important? Well, basically, it's just one number that tells you all about your respiratory health. And of course, it's much more useful than just looking at your steps or just at your heart rate, because on its own, these numbers do mean things, but they're not as important as when you sum them together and you actually track them over a week. Now, the Bip U does have a bit more functionality in terms of, it's got a world clock, that's lovely. It's got a time management tool called the Pomodoro. It's got a number of features which are slightly more interesting than the Honor Band 6. But again, they're both cheap, they're both budget, they look great, they look like smartwatches, But now let's get into the heart rate accuracy test. So as per usual, I was using the Polar H10 ECG chest strap while I was doing my exercise. And in this particular test, I was actually on the treadmill. I was running for 45 minutes. I ran just under 6 kilometers. And in those 45 minutes, I've been doing sort of intermittent running. So I did some sprinting, then I would slow down, then I'd sprint some more, slow down, and so forth. Well, I'm trying to lose some weight, so I'm finding that this sort of exercise does help me sweat most, and I do raise my fitness as well as losing quite a bit of water. So with this test, let's take a look at what the Polar H10 ECG chest strap has actually registered. And we can see that the average heart rate was registered at 128 beats per minute, while the max was 169 beats per minute. And we can see that the chart is rather spiked, because as I was sprinting, then I'd be slowing down, sprinting, slowing down, and so forth. So this is over 45 minutes. So there are a lot of points on these charts. So let's take a look at how the Amazfit Bip U actually managed to register this heart rate. Wow, Amazfit Bip U, the cheapest fitness tracker in the Amazfit range, basically destroyed this accuracy test. Let's take a look. So the average value for the heart rate was 129 beats per minute, while the max was 168 beats per minute. What that means is that for the average, we have an overstatement of 1 beat per minute, which is less than 1%, while for the max, we have an understatement of just 1 beat per minute, and that is also less than 1%. So, wow. Let's take a look now at what the Honor Band 6 came up with. Okay, so if we take a look at the Honor Band 6 result, well, we can see that the average heart rate was registered at 126 beats per minute, while the max was registered also just like the Amazfit Bip U at 168 beats per minute. So what this means? It means that the peak was underestimated by just 1 beat per minute, and that's again just under 1%. While the average was actually underestimated by just 2 beats per minute, and that is just over 1%. But in either case, these results are absolutely astounding and amazing, because optical heart rate sensors, which basically register your heart rate by emitting green LED light from the back of the smartwatch onto your skin, and by registering the reflection of the LED light, they are not as accurate as the chest strap, which is actually sitting on your chest right next to your heart. But we can see that the differences in the heart rate accuracy here between the optical heart rate sensors and the actual H10 ECG chest strap is minuscule. It's just under 1%. Well, for the average, it's just over 1% for the Honor Band 6. I can't say which one is better, because really, over 45 minutes and with all these heart rate spikes, this was a very difficult test, and both smart trackers performed absolutely beautifully. Anyway, thank you for watching this comparison and test against the Amazfit Bip U as well as the Honor Band 6. If you did enjoy the review, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Click on the red subscribe button below the video, and we'll see you in the next one.